What's Nabo? What's going on, everybody? We're back with some more Seven Deadly Sins. We got new Percival, and surprise, surprise, they dropped patch notes on global. So let's look. Okay, let's smash the like button, subscribe, turn on notification. He rizzed me up, y'all saw me. He stunned me. Like I was actually like speechless. High key. We got his It's not transformation. His translations. His Vorgies is a top 100 unit. I think I might just get one copy of him, but he's absolutely stupid. We got the pole draw. That ain't nothing new, right? Oh, it is. Okay, so let's take a look at his ultimate real quick. Yeah. Hero's Bloodline, Young Knight Lancelot. So let's take a look at his information. Okay, I guess we don't need to look at translations then because we got him right here. So he is, surprise, surprise, human and fairy. The first unit to actually have two races, like on them, not specified in a passive, like literally coming, whoa, hey, yo, comes as is a human and fairy, okay? But let's read his passive, bro. Heroic qualities. Applies insight on the heroes at the start of the battle for 3 turns. The hero's max HP increases by 8% for each applicable ally. So with its 24% max in PvP, participating in battle. When an applicable ally uses a single target attack skill, deals damage. Oh, so you can't just do like a debuff, like a single target debuff that does nothing, okay? And deals damage. The Mark of Insight is applied for 3 turns to a maximum of 1 enemy, okay? In addition, each time an applicable ally deals damage to an enemy afflicted with Mark of Insight during the ally's turn, the hero gains 1 piercing arrow, okay? Okay. And then at the start of the ally's turn, the hero's attack-related stats increase by 5% for each attack type skill and the enemy has. Okay, cool. And applicable allies are fairies, four knights of apocalypse, and humans. And then insight, applicable allies damage taken minus 30%. So okay, some nice damage reduction, cool. Human allies defense related stats plus 15% for each one participating in battle. Fairy allies basic stats plus 5% for each one participating in battle. So oh, defense, okay. I was like, why is this one so massive? But 15% total basic stats, and you get like 45% defense related. That could be good for like Naofumi. He could cook like you. Mark of Insight, crit defense minus 50%, and then piercing arrow, pierce rate plus 100%. All removed when dealing damage with. I think they meant to say all debuffs. All debuffs removed when dealing damage with an all target attack, other than the ultimate move, stacks up to 3 times. Huh? So he gets 300% pierce rate per piercing arrow. That's crazy. I was like astonished already, but now I'm just like thinking about 300% extra pierce is ridiculous. And then his new talent reveals the enemy's skills on the ally's turn. The talent is used. Remove debuffs from the hero equal to the number of enemies participating in battle. Cool down 3 turns. So I go first. I can use it 3 turns. After that, I could use it again. And remove debuffs. If they got 1 enemy left, I can only remove 1 debuff. Okay, cool. That's good enough because, you know, I mean, that's all that really matters. Like he, rough play, his single target skill inflicts impact damage equal to 450% of attack on 1 enemy. Impact is 3 times pierce rate and ignores resistance. Pretty good, pretty good, pretty good. Ignore is crazy, not just like lower or just like ignore like a certain percentage, just all of it is gone. Inflicts penetration damage equal to 250% of attack on all enemies. Penetration is attack plus 50% when using skills, increased damage dealt by half of his pierce. So he's gonna have like 300% pierce. That's like off just this alone, 150 scaled off this is stupid. What else? I think I'm missing something. Oh, it's his passive ultimate, because I'm like, I know he does something else, but I haven't read it yet. So Shining Road, increase the hero's attack related stats by 50% for 3 turns. The hero gains 3 piercing arrows, then in Then inflicts impact damage equal to 750% of attack on all enemies. Crazy. Then his passive here in his ultimate. When the hero is participating in battle, enemies afflicted by the Mark of Insight have their damage dealt decreased by 20%. We already got 30% damage reduction, and they have their damage dealt lower by 20%. And when the hero uses an all-target attack skill other than the ultimate move, additional damage is dealt equal to 100% of the damage dealt to the enemies afflicted with Mark of Insight. So, picture Milim AoE. I do an AoE with all these attack buffs on me, right? It does hella damage. The person with Mark of Insight doesn't die. They take all that damage that I dealt, which is ridiculous. It's like, it's kind of like death, but think it's like concentrate. It's like personal death, you know? Like, death is already stupid. Milim can theoretically wipe everybody, but let's say Milim doesn't wipe everybody. She does AoE and she does some death damage to everybody, and they're still alive, right? He's like, oh, I do AoE with my three arrows on me, right? My pierce is through the roof. I do it could be a level one. I do like a million, right? Everybody dies, right? I do a million total damage. 100% of that goes to that one person. Like, that nigga is taking 2 million damage. Also, this guy is coming out tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, tonight, literally like Friday morning, like at 12 a.m. For me specifically. So, and around 18 hours, he'll actually release on global JPKR, whatever version you play. But yeah, piercing arrow, pierce rate plus 100%, all remove them dealing. Yeah, we already went through that. Impact is 3x pierce rate and ignores resistance. So he seems very pierce. You know what he reminds me? He really reminds me of like Fatoria and them, like when they came out earlier this year, just like riddled with like pierce. Not too much like crit chance, but I feel like it really don't matter because he's gonna have so much, well, not so much, but like a good amount of attack related here, a whole bunch of pierce. He's gonna have, I'm not gonna say, well, from what I saw in the showcase, he looked very, very strong. But in my experience, pierce units that were like riddled with pierce and nothing else typically don't perform the best in my eyes. Now, if we just take a gander at what released, was it this year or earlier or last year? I have no clue. Fatoria and Glass. It feels like they came out last year, but I feel like they came out this year. Fatoria came out, pierce, crit chance, always critting. Glass comes out, pierce, 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 pierce. So much pierce, so much pierce. She does the same amount of damage every single time. On a rank one, she does the same amount of damage. When I have a level three with her skill, I do 300K. And her level one does 300K too. Now, I'm not sure how much damage he gonna do, but from what I saw in the showcases, his damage did vary from like turn one with no arrows, like 300K. But then like at turn two or something like that, when he has like, when the enemy has a whole hand of like attack cards, right? That he gets more attack related, then he's doing like stupid, insane, ridiculous, you know, not like ult type stuff. Like what Escanor can do on his ultimate, like 1 million, he's doing that like on like his AoEs, you know? So I would like to actually get my hands on him and play with him. Hey, yo, pause, Devo, this is a minor. But he looks to be very strong. So let's take a look at what his dupe levels are. So you don't get the enemy's damage dealt decreased by 20% until 3-6. And then your additional damage dealt is 60% at 1-6. That's fantastic, ladies and gentlemen. Because in the live stream, in the amazing chat, we were discussing whether or not, like, how well is this going to be at level 1. So even at level 1, he's still doing a good amount of damage. 60%, that's fantastic, man. And then we got Vorgis. When participating in battle with an applicable ally, the heroes and the applicable allies' defense-related stats increased by 30%. Ew. Not even a ball, like, I mean, he don't got the hand, so he got to be on field. Spike, decrease skill rank, cancel buffs and stances, and then stun for 2 turns. Cool. And then his banner, Escanor, Somnok, Arthur, Hell, Demon King, Mael, Liz, Lightbond, Daddy. Yep, you know he had to get on there. Percival, Gelda, Blue, Infinity, Merlin, Red Chalice. This banner is fantastic. I can't look at anybody on this banner and be like, oh, they're absolute shit. Other than like this guy. And maybe, nah, because they're usable somehow. This banner is just good. overall. I can nitpick and say like, ooh, why are they there? But like, bro, they're good. They're usable, man. But yeah, don't pick up the this shit. Don't get that, bro. Don't get the power up stuff, bro. That's a scam. We got a new chapter. Outfits look pretty good, and then there's his new ability. It's just called talent. It's not even anything special. So you just like you go first. You can use it on your turn if you want to. I imagine this is probably gonna be a thing, and it's gonna be super restrictive. Coming with like maybe like Ragnarok and like catastrophe stuff in the future. Maybe you might have to be on a full catastrophe team. Who knows? But bro is officially biracial in Grand Cross. You'll love to see it. Then we got the I love this global side of things. Book of Heroes chapter 2, so we get some free to play goodies from here. What else? Oh, we got rules in geared PvP. It says elite. Does that mean geared? I think so. We want increased pierce rate out what by 20%. Oh, his pierce rate is gonna be crazy. Change the lifesteal of all heroes in battle to 0% and prevent it from increasing. Oh, so like Transcendent Bond who can give you HP related, it's like nah, you can't heal at all. Okay, that's cool. No, this is bad for Gelda literally can't like build up, because she like builds up depending on how much lifesteal like they heal from. So she's like dead that way completely, so no Gelda's then. Oh, this is for top 100. Never mind, I'm tripping. So will this even affect people? Probably not. And then we got a new card set. Increase allies basic stats by 5%. Also increase allies attack by 2% each time an ally of Fortnite's Apocalypse uses a skill to damage enemies. Oh, okay. It's not specified. I mean, you can use it anywhere, so that's cool. And then we got Queen Liz Holy Relic. Don't know why she's not related to Lancelot at all. Okay, cool. When an ally affected by intervention of light attacks an applicable ally, all critical strikes damage taken decreased by 50%. Whoa, that's good. Hold on. That's better than I thought. Well, Mason was reading it, I was like, maybe. And then when Goddess Wrath reaches 4 stacks, 2 debuffs are removed from applicable allies and applicable allies attack related stats increased by 20% for 2 turns. Took it a little bit. Okay. I see. And then yep, coins. Bell just whoop-de-doo. What's this? Knighthood competition. Okay. New bundles. Yep. Where's the gear stuff? Are they giving out like the 15% gear rolls? Cause I would love that IQ. Anvils, diamonds, no 15% gear, unfortunately. Legendary seal. Okay, then we got the diamond login bonus. We got the jumping box event. You got a free multi on Lancelot, and then supernova jump box. Okay. We're looking fine. We got the blessings event. We got the card flip event. We got the event boss parade. Yep. We got Heroes Arena coming back. Give my LR coins. They changed the layout a bit. Is that pretty much it? I think that's pretty much it. That's noteworthy. We got the lucky bag event, so you can get that. You can get lucky with some gems. We got the exchange. Oh, W. It's your exchange event. We'd love to see this because we get to exchange the crystals. I know you got a million giant crystals, bro. Nobody, we ain't getting no new meta giant like every day. So if you got like 1,000 of them, you can trade and get whatever is needed for Lancelot. So we got a new outfit for Sobnok. Oh, I'm there. The number one Sobnok Glazier. You already know how it goes, man. Battle event, whoop-de-doo. And then we got the times 3 for Transcendent Bird. So that's going to be pretty nice. What is that? Loyalty item for each demonic beast battle will be added gradually. Oh, so this one, you can just like craft a relic if you get those. Okay, cool. Okie dokie. And then these seal things can be exchanged for, because you get a whole lot of them up there. Y'all saw, we passed them. That's pretty much it. Yeah, I think so. Let me know what y'all think about Lancelot. To me, he looks very, very, very impressive. He's like the strongest Pierce unit ever. I feel like he might have too much Pierce. I don't know what they were thinking, high key. He probably didn't even need all that much Pierce. He probably just needed like maybe 100, but they're giving like, bro, legit like enough Pierce. Like, he's gonna have like 400% Pierce or 500% Pierce or something stupid like that. So it makes me think, Since he is riddled with Pierce, maybe the units that come out for New Year's may have something to do with like kind of like Green Valenti-esque, you know, OG Green Valenti, like cutting like people's Pierce in half or something like that, or like just nuking their Pierce or something stupid. Who knows? But for the time being, he looks very impressive to me. Let me know what you think. He will be dropping tonight in 18 hours for global and JP players, for everybody. So let me know what you think, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Y'all stay good, and I love you.